Welcome back. The Maize Association of Nigeria says its targeted projection of harvested maize, estimated at around 25 million tons of maize, might not be achieved in the 2020 farming season. The president of MAAN, Bello Abubakar, while speaking to newsmen in Abuja, said this and said this is because of the current coronavirus pandemic being witnessed globally. Abubakar called on state governments to support maize farmers by partnering with the association and providing more lands for maize planting, while also tasking farmers not to take advantage of the current situation by inflating their prices.
We sincerely plead with states that have comparative advantage to maize production to partner with man by providing large area of arable lands for cultivation by our farmers. In order to sustain this great step taken by the government, grain farmers and merchants should not use the opportunity to unnecessarily increase the price of maize grain. We should also contribute our quota by maintaining reasonable prices. We wish to pray to the federal government to kindly reactivate the guarantee minimum price committee. This will give farmers confidence that no matter the situation as regarding the cost of production and market forces. The farmers know that the less of price of this produce and the end users too will have instruments to bargain for price. For this year planting season, that we are targeting 25 million tons of maize to be produced. But due to some certain challenges of COVID-19 and the insecurity in this country, so we are expecting that about 30 to 25% of that target can be reduced.
We're now joined by a seasoned farmer in Kiru Okpareke to shed more light on this. Thank you for joining us, Nkiru.
Thank you very much. Good morning.
Good morning. What is your reality as a farmer in the face of COVID-19? How different has it been?
It's really been a very big challenge for most farmers. You remember the lockdown started just at the beginning of the rainy season planting. And so farmers couldn't go to their farms. There was a lot of challenges. Security organizations were stopping us all the time. We couldn't get to our farms. Then inputs we use, a lot of inputs we use. Though Nigeria has been agriculture for years, a lot of inputs we use are still imported. So farmers can't get their hands on fertilizers. Even when you can get your hands on the inputs, some of them have doubled based on the increase in dollars and non-availability. Another thing is that a lot of countries too have shut down on exports. So inputs that we're bringing from other countries, lots of countries are now doing protectionism, keeping their own inputs and things they need for farming to be able to feed their people. And because we depend on a lot of countries to get the things we need in farming, it's been a challenge. Then of course, insecurity problem that many farmers have going to the farm. So COVID has really impacted. At a time when we should have been at the farm planting to be harvesting now, just because really we're a rain-fed farming nation, many farmers couldn't get to the farm. So even if you go to the markets now, food prices have more than doubled.
That's scary. COVID-19 has also opened everyone up to exploring new ways of doing things. What are such options that are available now for agriculture?
Well, though he has opened up, what can you do in agriculture? You still have to go to the farm. You can't do agriculture by a Zoom call. You can't do by a Skype call. You still have to physically go there. So the only other thing he has opened up for farmers is have new ways of retailing their product. So instead of sending them to the shops or to the market, a lot of farmers are now trying to sell their produce and their online platforms, WhatsApp platforms and stuff like that. Those are really about the only opportunities that have changed for farmers. They put access to selling to the last man through other retail options online. But apart from them, every other thing you have to do in farming is physical. We have to be physically there to do it. It's only the retail angle that's changed, but retail angle is just one part. The logistics still hasn't changed. You still have to get it from the farm. You still have to be physically there to have it moved. So that's about the only change that farmers have experienced, the access to the customers using online platform. But every other thing still has to be done the way it used to be done physically.
Okay, and Nick, if you can squeeze this in 15 seconds, I want to ask about Do you think that, you know, consumers should be worried about, you know, how, you know, the rest of the year turns since farming has been so difficult lately?
Yes, consumers should be worried. Prices are going to go up and there won't be enough food for people to consume. So consumers should really be worried, and they need to start speaking to government to support farmers so we can increase production. We have the land, we have the expertise, but we need support to be able to increase the production. It's actually a food security issue. If people don't eat, that's a major security problem in the country.